Hello everyone, here we are, Robin the Sudoku Guy with a special video this time. It's video number 100. Now I've done over 150 videos over the years, but this one is very special because we have a special guest. I'll introduce our guest in a minute. Couple of things first. First of all, a lot of people have come to me and said, or players have asked me, why don't I do other patterns of Sudoku? Well, it's hard to do that when you've got a board like this. But here's a suggestion. Go to Amazon.com, put in Sudoku patterns or variants, and you'll come up with all kinds of different ways to do Sudoku puzzles. One of them is called Samurai. Have a look at this. In this case, you've got five puzzles, and the whole idea is that when you're doing them, it takes a fair while, when you're doing them, you've just got to be aware of another corner of another puzzle at the same time. It's fun. And there's other books that you can get, like this one here. This one is also you can get from Amazon, and you can give that a try. If you purchase a book from Amazon, you can try those other puzzles if you wish. Now, this particular puzzle is unique in this respect. I found this in a book that I bought many years ago. And this book was published, I think it had Sudoku puzzles from London Times. Thank you, London Times. But I wanted to show you this one because it is a traditional layout and it has what we call mirror image in it. Let me show you. If you look at this, you'll find that if you imagine a line along the middle here, this top half is reflected like a mirror in the bottom half. So you have six, one, two, three, and you've got one, two, three. You've got one, two, one, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, and so on. It can also reflect this way in a mirror image. If you put a line down the middle here, you've got line down mid here, then this side reflects this side. For example, this reflects that 8. These two reflects the 5-2, and so on, all the way across. So what you've got on this side is what you've got on that side, but of course different numbers, but the pattern is reflected or mirror imaged. So without further ado, I want to take this opportunity to introduce a special guest today. Her name is Cathryn. Cathryn, welcome aboard. Cathryn has been my wonderful partner for many years and she supported me for all those years. She's supported me as I've been doing this site and she's a very good at solving Sudoku puzzles. She learned a lot from me, but she also has her own method. And I'm going to get her to start the puzzle the way she likes to start a puzzle. Everybody has their own system. She has her own system as well. So take it away, Cathryn. This is all yours.
Thank you, Mr. Sudoku Guy. He will do it with me. I won't have to do it all on my own. But when I did this, I always like to do the ones he's going to be teaching you mm-hmm. to see how he goes about them. Mm-hmm. So when I finished this one, I had put in no little numbers. And I said, teach them to do it without putting in any small numbers.
Because I've always taught learners to put, there's usually the Snyder method where you put little numbers in two cells to begin with. And then later on, when it gets really tough, then you have to put all the little numbers in. So Cathryn, go ahead.
But I figure you can get away with a lot with Sudoku. So here's the way I went about doing this one. And please chime in anytime because you may also find that sometimes I'm saying something, jumping from here to there, when you think, wait a minute, they won't know what the intermediate steps were, so I apologize. Okay?
She's very fast. She finishes the puzzle before I do.
But not always as well as he does. So I do something that, what do you call it, where you take each number and you check all over to see?
Yeah. Well, you start at one and go up to 9, don't you?
I do, but I don't just go across this way.
I do across those three blocks, those three blocks, those three blocks, these three blocks, these three blocks, these three blocks, using tap, middle, bottom, TMB, and LCR. But Cathryn does that too. You'll see later, okay?
But I kind of make leaps of faith. So I don't just, I look all over the board to look for the ones. And so when I look at this one, I see there's a one here, and a one here. But if I go across this way and down this way, I don't see any hope for the ones right now. They're pretty hopeless. There's no place I have to that I wouldn't have to put in a small number, and I'm not going to do that. So I go on to the twos. And I look, well, I don't really. I should do it this way. I'll show you how he would do it, and then I'll show you how I do it. Because his way is a logical way. You would go across looking for twos and see where you get with those. By that time, I've already gone right straight to here. And I see there's a two here and a two here. So what is that?
Right and a left.
And a left. Whoops, I'm knocking your board over. So I can already put a big number. He says it's not big enough. But that's my little two. And so then I've got a two here and a two here. And rather than being as logical, I'm sorry, as my partner is, he's so logical and so good at this, I just follow along. Okay, I've got all the twos here. I've got a two here. So I can't have any twos there or there. Can't, no place to put it there either. I've got...
I see something.
Two. Oh, there's a two. See, you're cut. I'm on the wrong... Oh, you put it on because you make nice lines.
Okay, I'll put in a two there.
Don't do it there.
Up there. Okay.
Don't you do it.
Oh, and that's the wrong spot. Sorry. It's over here because there's a two there.
Yeah.
Okay. That's called ramification. So, nearly missed the ramification. And tell you what, it's so easy to miss the ramification.
I miss them all the time. But as he says, you can always come back to them. Mm-hmm. You don't lose anything. So there are no other places that we can put a big number two in. We could put some little number twos, but I'm not letting him do it this time.
See, if I had a beginner person with me, this two and that two means that there's two little twos there and there. But leave it in your head. Use your memory. Okay.
Threes. Oh, hopeless up here. There's one three here. I can't do any one three there. Can't put any threes there because we're not putting in any little numbers. We got a three here. No, that would require putting in little numbers, and I'm not letting him do that. Ooh, bad person.
It's okay.
So we'll go on to the fours. Mm-hmm. We've got a four here and a four here, mm-hmm. But unfortunately, over here, we would have to have little numbers. Nah, not this time.
And you mean a little four there and a little four there?
We're not going to do that because I'm going to make them feel so powerful.
Okay, well, I got to keep that in your head.
They can do it. I swear.
Remember
it. Okay, so fours and then here. So no way to, nothing. There's nothing we can do with those without putting in little numbers. So we'll go to the fives. Only one five here, so can't put in any. A five here, can't put any there. A five here, can't put any there. And if you go this way, same thing. We've got a five here. Not too many spaces.
We could have a five there and there if you put little numbers in. But
no.
Don't put it in. Okay.
No, these are brilliant people out there.
I know they are. By the way, this is designed, this particular tutorial, for all players, whether you're a beginner or an advanced player. There's always something to learn. Go ahead.
So sixes. We're going on to the sixes, and it's going to be fun. Mm. Up here we've got a six. Here we've got a six, so we can't put any sixes across here. You can't put any sixes across here. But we're going to look at it crosswise. We've got a six here and a six here. Therefore, we can't put a six here. We can't put a six here. We can't put a six there. We can't put a six there. But we can put one
there.
Right there.
Good. We got number. Fantastic.
And then we're going to look at ramifications. Robin loves ramifications. There's a six here. So you can't put any sixes down here. There is Oh, I know what he's going to type. But I'm not going to let him do it. He wants to give you a couple of pairs, and I'm not going to let him do it because there's a six here. Mm-hmm. So we've got a six across here, mm-hmm. a six down here. Can't put any sixes there or there, but we can. Would you do it, please, Mr. Yeah. Sudoku?
Yes. Now, let me say how that, continue on with that. Was there any ramifications?
We've got two sixes down here, mm-hmm. one across here, so that would be
six and six.
So we're not going to do that.
Any other ramifications?
Let's just see. We've got six across here, and look at this, Mr. Sudoku.
That's a six. Middle, top, and bottom. Can I put it in for you?
Yep, please do, because you make really nice
noise. Okay. Well done. Now, I'm going to interrupt here because you've probably seen me do a tutorial where I say something like this. There's many ways to cook an egg. And sometimes there's many ways to solve a number. Now, here's something to look at. If you look at this block here, you have a six and an eight there, which means you can't have a six and an eight there. So here we had two empty cells, which make up a six and eight, because the six and eight have to be there. We've put the six in there, so therefore this has to be the eight. That 6, 8 could not be in here. We put the six there because of that six. Now we have one left on this side, and that's an eight, so I'm going to put it in because that is a good ramification for seeing that 6, 8 there. Okay, go ahead.
Now we
do sevens.
Sevens. I was going straight to nines, skipping sevens and eights. Okay, sevens. Can't put a seven here. Mm-hmm. Seven there. Can't put a seven there or there. Can't, if you look up this way, there are no sevens to interrupt, so no, you'd have to put two mm-hmm. sevens there. Mm-hmm. Today, I'm stretching them.
Okay. Well, let's go then to eights.
Well, let's go to eight. Okay, so we've got an eight across here, mm-hmm. eight across there. So an eight could go in any of those. And
too many, okay. Nines.
Yeah, nines. Mm-hmm. Nines, no nines up here. Mm-hmm. One nine here. Mm-hmm. Anything that it needs? Mm-hmm. We know that the 9 is going to have to go in here.
Yes.
It can't go there.
Yeah.
So
keep
we can
that in
bring
your head.
That 9 all the way across here.
Uh-huh. Didn't help us.
Okay. We can go there, there now.
Okay, we've gone to 1 to 9. Now, let's look and see what I have noticed since Cathryn has gone from 1 to 9. Here we have a 1 on the left. Here we have a 1 in the center. We can't have a one there. We can have a one up there now. So put the one in. Well, let's make it a bit darker, dear, so we can see it. Okay. Now, therefore, we know that the one's got to be over here, but that is interesting. Here is something that I noticed when we were doing that. We're at this stage now. Is there any place where there's only two cells left? Can you see any? No, I don't see any. What about three cells left?
Quite a few.
Yeah. Well, now, you can take your pick. You've got this one here with three cells. You've got this one here with three cells. You've got this one here with three cells. We'll work on those first, shall we? But let's work on this one first. Would you like to work? What goes in there?
I would. The numbers that are missing are one.
A one.
A five.
A five.
And a seven.
Notice how quickly she did that. You know, when you've done Sudoku puzzles and you've worked out, you know, what's missing, and you, when you first start out, you count up 1 to 9 to find out what's missing. She's done so many of them over the years, she gets them very quickly. So you said there was a 1, a 5, and a 7.
And the nice thing about that.
Yeah.
Sharpen your memories here. A 1, 5, and a 7 here. There are only two more numbers that can go in this column, and that's a 4 and a 9.
Mm.
It doesn't help us much, but
yeah, that's good observation. Yeah. Watch for rows, columns, and blocks with only two left. Now, here's something.
And
What goes in here? Anything?
We already did that.
Well, we have a 5-1 there.
1-5, so a 7 goes there.
Oh, a 7 goes there. Can I put it in for you?
Yes, please.
I'm shaking. I'm nervous. Okay.
That's because now, of me.
Now we have a 1-5 matching pair in here. We've got to keep that in our head. Okay. Anywhere else where there's only 3 left? Oh, there's 2 left now. There's 2 left there.
Yeah, but it's an 8 and a 9.
Oh, look at that. There's an 8. Look. 8 and a 9. Make it a big one. I'll make it big so people can see it. Okay. Oh, boy, look. Oh, dear.
Oh, that's a mess.
That's a mess.
That's an 8. I don't make nice ones.
So if it was an 8 and a 9 that was missing.
Then you put an 8.
We named a 9, big 9, big flat 9. Okay, fine. Well, we've got a whole row now. Fantastic.
And then here's where my mind goes, ding, because I immediately saw that there was an 8 here. And there are only 3 numbers missing here. Mm-hmm. There's an 8 here, so it can't go there. There's an 8 here, so it can't go there. So it has to go in the middle of that.
There's an 8 here, and there's an 8 here. That's brilliant. I didn't see that. Thank you, dear. Well, that's interesting because that's going to give us 2 empty cells, isn't it?
And it's going to give us a whole row because we're only missing a
4
and a
7.
And what's here?
Oh, there's a 4 there, so that has to be a 7.
Yeah.
Okay. So you put the 4 in, nice big one. Dark, if you can, press hard. Okay. That's it. Now, this is exciting, because remember we talked about this, which is all to do with the memory. We said a 4 could go there or there, but they can't go there now. We got a 4 there, so guess what? It has to go here. Now.
Can I go on with 4s?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead with 4. I can see what you're going to do. I think I know what you're going to do.
Yeah, because we're only missing 3 numbers here, and what are they?
Here?
Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 9.
Yep. There's a 4 here, so it can't go there.
Uh-huh.
There's a 4 here, so it can't go there. So where's the 4 going there?
It has to go in the middle. And now we're left with
3 and a 9.
And a 3 and a 9 it's here and a here. We don't know. We've got to keep that in our head. Boy.
Another one.
Oh, yeah. But just a minute. I just saw something here. This is neat. This 7 has to go there. Can you tell me why?
Okay. No.
Sorry, I put you on the spot there, dear.
You did, because I don't do the puzzle this way. And you can't put a 7 there, but it could go there or there.
Yeah. Can it go there?
No, can't go there because of that.
Because of that 7.
Oh, okay. Okay, I get it. Okay. So there's a 7 here. Yeah. It took me a minute.
Yeah.
So you can't have 7 that's taken care of. Here, there has to be a 7 there or there.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, it can't be there or there.
Therefore, it has to be there. Okay.
Oh, you got me on that one.
Okay. It's fun working together on this. We help each other out. Okay.
Now, I want to show them something really cool.
You go ahead, love. We have 2 empty here. So.
Okay, well, we'll do those first then.
Okay.
But they're a 1 and a 5.
1 and a 5. So?
But there's a 5
there's
there.
A 5 already in that block. So you can't put a 5 there. Good. I'll put the 5 in for you.
No, put a 1 there.
That's right. I'll put the 1 in there. Whoopsie, whoopsie, whoopsie. See, well, that's one. We help each other. Correct each other. We put a 1 there.
Yep, 1.
And well, that means that this becomes the 5.
Yep.
If this becomes the 5, then this is the only one left in there, and it has to be the 1. Okay, well, that was neat. Now, there's any place where there's 2 left, 2 cells left.
Okay, but
you're getting excited, aren't you, dear?
I am, because here, there are just 3 left.
That's true.
But there's 7, 8, and 9.
Uh-huh. We have a 7 and an 8. So that has to be a 9. Okay, let's put it in. Okay, now we have a 7, 8 matching pair.
You've already done without putting any little numbers in?
So we've got a 7, 8 matching pair. Now there's other places with only 2 cells left. Where are they? There's 1 here, and there's 1 there.
Let's do this one. first. Okay. Well, I think we couldn't do that one.
Yeah, we could.
Because it was a 3 and a 9.
Yeah, 3 and a 9. That's right.
Okay, so this...
Oh, 3 and a 9. You just said 3 and a 9, and I just saw this. When you put that 9 in, we didn't put it there. Does that make sense? Center,
yeah,
left, right.
And not only that, another thing that I look at is there's a 9 here, so they can't go here or here.
Hmm.
And it can't go anywhere else but there.
Okay, let's put it in.
Gee.
We're working together on this. Now there's only one left in here, and it is a 3. Now, getting back to these two empty cells, we know what these are, 7, 8.
Well, we know there's a 5 there.
A 5 has to be there
because
the 5 can't be there.
Can I put my wonky 5
in? Yeah, put a big 5. Press hard, big 5.
This one doesn't do very well, right?
No, it doesn't. I'll do it for you, dear, so people can see it easily. Okay. Oops.
Yeah, this is a bit... See, and it leaves a blue spot, so...
Yeah.
We'll get
we
better
rid.
Just forget this one.
I'll give you the pen. Okay. Oh, it's still blue.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll make this into a 5.
And that means a 3 has got to go there.
It's the only one left. Okay. If that is a 3, what are the ramifications? Middle, bottom, top. So they're all there. Okay. Yeah. Here we have a 3. Ooh.
Now we've got
3. We've got a 3, it's got to go in there somewhere. We've always got a 3 there, haven't we?
You're just crazy.
Yeah. Okay, any other places where there's only 3 left or 2 left? Oh, well, look at this column. We missed that whole column. There's something missing there.
There's a 7 missing there.
7 goes there. Okay, let's put the 7 in there. There we go. Now.
What are we missing here?
A 3 and a 4.
Four. Yeah, and
we don't know which ones yet.
And here we're just missing a 3 and an 8. Oh.
3, aha! Look, 3 has to go here because you can't, bottom, top, middle. Because the 3 has to be there, so that center, left, right. It has to be there, center, left, right. It has to be here.
I said 3 and 8, but I was wrong.
Uh-huh.
But the 3 was the...
The 3 was correct.
that was the one, the real one. Okay. So then here, what are we missing?
We're missing just one number. Oh. A 5?
A 5.
Okay, I'll put it in for you. Okay.
Oh my gosh, look at this. We're going so lickety-split through
this.
Yeah,
we're doing pretty well.
Well, did we look at this one?
What are the numbers missing there?
5 and 7.
A 5. No, it can't be a 5 and a 7. We got a 7.
We got a
missing
5.
A 3. We're missing a 3 and a 5.
3? Oh, well, look at this. We got a 3 here.
So that'll have to be the 5 and that'll have to be the 3. Yeah. I don't know. Can you see what's going to happen now? The ramifications coming up.
This
we'll make this a 5 because we knew that because of a 5 down here and the 5 up there, it had to be somewhere in here. So that's a 5. That's a 5. One of these is going to be a 5. Now, because there's one left in here, that's a 3. And the ramification of that 3, that can't be there. It can't be there. It has to go up there. So we have top, middle, and a bottom. Fantastic. Wait, now, tell me, what's left on that block? There's only one left.
4.
A 4? Okay, let's put a 4 in. Okay. Now,
Mr. Ramifications.
Yes, Mr. Ramifications.
You got a 4 here, so it can't be there, or there. Got a 4 here, so it can't be there, so your 4 is going to have to go there.
Did you get that? Wasn't that quick? She sees things so quickly. Middle, bottom, has to be on the top. It can't be there because of this 4, so it goes there. Okay, now... Oh, I can see all kinds of things here.
Can I do 2s?
Twos?
Yes.
Yeah, bye. Go ahead. Well, tell me.
Okay, keep that open because you're going to need to write here in a minute. So up here, we're just missing a 2, a 5, and a 9.
Uh-huh.
There's a 2
there's a
here.
Two here.
Can't go there.
Okay.
There's a 2 here.
Can't go
there.
There.
So the 2
only place it can
go
is there. Fantastic.
And then we're only missing a 5 and a 9, and there's a 5 here, so
that can't go there, so that'll have to be a 9. Therefore, this is a
five.
And if that's a five and that's a five has to be in here. What's missing?
Well, it can't go there because there's a five.
Five there, so it has to go there. Now we only have one left in that block.
Eight.
Brilliant. Eight. Now, oh boy, I think we're ready to look at this column again. There's only two left there. What's missing?
Okay.
It's a four. Well, a four has to go there. Center, left, right. A four has to go there. And therefore, the only number left in this column is a nine. Nine. Nine, nine, that is correct. Make that a nine. Now we only have two left, and I think there's a one in there somewhere.
Well, it's a one and a two, but look.
Oh, you can't have a two there. They don't have to go there. She notices, she knows immediately what's missing, and this has to be the one. Let's double check. Center, bottom, no, middle, bottom, top. We're making good progress. We're getting there.
Well, and now we can do something with the one.
With the one?
Yeah, we've got a one here.
One.
We've got a one here.
Yeah.
So we have to have a one here or here.
But there's a one over here.
Exactly.
Oh, let's put that one in. Dude, that was a pun. Put that one in. Okay.
Oh, well.
Okay. Very good. Now, in this column, we've got one left. No, one empty number. One number to go. An eight. She knows it already. Now that's going to be interesting.
Yeah, because now we can finish off the
eight. Eight, eight, eight is this way. Eight, eight. This has to become an eight. Bottom, top, middle. Okay.
And we're missing an eight in the middle. But and we now know where it goes because it can't.
That eight was this. Well, good point. Very good. You remembered that. This eight, we remember we had a 7-8 matching pair here.
Yeah.
Now that we have an eight up there, that has to become a seven. Ooh, this is running out too. And this becomes the eight. Good. Now.
Look, this poor thing only, is oh,
it's feeling lonely.
Himself.
It's a seven. Is it?
It is.
Left, right, center. Put a seven. Okay. And
oh, that gives us a seven in here.
That's a seven. It's got to be in there. Can't put a seven there because of that seven. Yeah. So this becomes the seven. So we have a top, middle, bottom. Okay, we're getting closer.
Yeah.
Oh, this column here only has one left. And it has to be
nine.
Right on. Right, center, left. Make this big nine. Okay.
And if we look to the left.
To the left. Oh, look at this. We have a ramification.
Yeah.
A top, a bottom. This has to be in the middle. Now we only have one left in this block or one left in that column, which
one
is that one?
Lonely six.
Six. Check it out. Right, center, left. Yeah, everything's right. Six.
And now there's no six in
here. We're almost there.
Where's our six?
Oh, look. There's top, bottom, middle. Here, this six goes in here. And we have one left to go. And
okay,
that is
I get to put it in.
You put
messy
it in.
Messy and light as it will be.
Yeah, press hard.
Okay. Last one's going to be a four.
Fantastic. Well done, dear. You know, this has been a lot of fun. Thank you so much, dear, for being
And now you can see why he's the teacher and I'm the student.
She did all right, didn't she? You know, this is an experiment that we thought we'd try. I hope you learned something, whether you're a beginner or whether you're an advanced player. It was fun doing it with a friend. And thank you for being part of this.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Bye for now. You say bye for now.
Bye for now.